Hello, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study odd chain fatty acid oxidation. We already studied the beta-oxidation pathway accomplishes the complete degradation of saturated fatty acids having an even number of carbon atoms. So these odd chain fatty acids are very rare in nature and also in our diet, and as a result of metabolism in our body, usually we will find 3 carbon and 5 carbon odd chain fatty acids. But if you explore recent literature, our body can synthesize some of the C15 and C17 odd chain fatty acids from the gut, or some foods like milk, meat, and some fruits like durian contains odd chain fatty acids. So today I am going to explain by taking a 15 carbon odd chain fatty acid, and it is called pentadecaenoic acid. This is a systematic name. The initial oxidation of odd chain fatty acid is through beta oxidation. That means every 2 carbon atoms are removed as acetyl CoA. Since this is a 15 carbon fatty acid, so we will get through beta oxidation 6 molecule of acetyl CoA. Unlike beta oxidation of even number fatty acids, you can see here the remaining part of this pentadecaenoic acid, we have 3 carbon. Unlike 2 carbon, here we have 3 carbon, which released as propionyl-CoA. This is the shortest odd chain fatty acid. You must notice here, odd chain fatty acids yield acetyl-CoA as well as propionyl-CoA. So we know acetyl-CoA can enter TCA cycle and generate ATP. So what is the fate of this propionyl-CoA? This propionyl-CoA, which is generated as a result of beta oxidation of odd chain fatty acids, converted to D-stereoisomer of methylmalonyl-CoA. This reaction requires energy in the form of hydrolysis of ATP to ADP and inorganic phosphate. This reaction requires carbon dioxide or bicarbonate. So the name of the enzyme is propionyl-CoA carboxylase. So this reaction is similar to pyruvate carboxylase in carbohydrate metabolism. Since this is a carboxylase enzyme catalyzed reaction, we require biotin as a cofactor. So biotin is a coenzyme for propionyl-CoA carboxylase. This D-methylmalonyl-CoA isomerized to L-methylmalonyl-CoA. So this is catalyzed by methylmalonyl-CoA racemase or epimerase. There is a rearrangement of atoms within the molecule. So D stereoisomer converted to L stereoisomer. Now this L methylmalonyl-CoA converted to succinyl-CoA with the help of an enzyme called methylmalonyl-CoA mutase. Again, this is isomerase. Okay. Isomerase could be epimerase, racemase, mutase. These are the different types of isomerase enzyme. So this is also an isomerase, which again makes intramolecular rearrangement of methylmalonyl-CoA and converted to succinyl-CoA. And this reaction requires vitamin B12 as a coenzyme like D-adenosylcobalamin. We know succinyl-CoA, which is an intermediate of citric acid cycle, so it can directly enter TCA cycle. We also studied in the carbohydrate metabolism, TCA cycle is an anaphylerotic. That means intermediates can be utilized for the formation of some of the important compounds. At the same time, same intermediate can be replenished by some other compounds. This is the one more example where succinyl-CoA can be utilized for the formation of heme along with glycine. At the same time, this succinyl-CoA can be replenished by metabolism or catabolism of odd chain fatty acids. So this is actually oxidation of odd chain fatty acid. So you should remember, odd chain fatty acids not only generate acetyl CoA, it also gives shortest odd chain fatty acid, that is 3-carbon propionyl CoA, and this propionyl CoA, with the help of propionyl CoA carboxylase, a biotin dependent enzyme, converted to D-isomer of methyl melonyl CoA, which isomerized to L stereoisomer, that is L methyl melonyl CoA, and this L methyl melonyl CoA, with the help of another isomerase, that is methyl melonyl CoA mutase, and D-adenosyl cobalamin or coenzymes derived from vitamin B12 to form succinyl-CoA, which is actually an intermediate of citric acid cycle or TCA cycle. These odd chain fatty acids are glucogenic because they can enter citric acid cycle through succinyl-CoA.